After the chaos and bloodshed of World War II, the aftermath was what provided people hope and a short-lived peace. The United Nations was created, and people across the globe believed that happiness and safety were possible.
The UN 2030 agenda envisages a world of universal respect for human rights and human dignity, the rule of law, justice, equality, and non-discrimination.
One of these goals, and perhaps the most salient, is good health and well-being. It is the third sustainable development goal and is instrumental in determining the progress of any country. Annually, it is estimated that 44,000 women die due to preventable pregnancy-related causes in India. Proper care of both the mother and the child and the accessibility of quality health care to all sectors of society are potential solutions.
Malnutrition, lack of medical aid and deprivation of basic amenities such as clean drinking water attributed to the death of about 8 lakh children in India in 2017 alone.
Communicable diseases like malaria, typhoid, hepatitis, jaundice and tuberculosis are not only common in India but across the globe. The most efficacious way to prevent communicable diseases are self-care and hygiene.
Unhealthy lifestyle patterns and unrelenting work culture resulting in non-communicable diseases such as heart disorders, cancer and diabetes are the main rationales behind 60% of deaths in India. India is the first to adapt the Global Monitoring Framework on Non-Communicable Diseases to reduce the related deaths.
In 2016, 9,474 students have killed themselves in India. Most parents want their children to be high achievers rather than allow them to follow their own dreams. Talking about it, taking a stand for self and believing in self would minimize the drive towards suicide and mental pressure. In India, mental health is not always open to social acceptance and public discussion. It is a major component of an individual's health, and therapy for the same should not be yet another element under social scrutiny.
Speaking on the phone while driving, drunk driving, and not abiding by the traffic laws are recurrent and result in more than 1,200 road crashes every day in India.
India, being the second most populous country, is in desperate need of family planning. Controlling population growth nips the problems in the bud.
National Health Protection Mission, or Modicare, is to offer about 500 million people living in poverty up to 5 lakh rupees of health coverage every year. And now, people living in remote areas have access to quality medical aid.
Environmental pollution is the biggest threat to sustainable development. India is immensely polluted with choking smog, dying plants, impure water and scorching summers.
Tobacco consumption has a powerful hold over the progress of health in India. The Indian government discourages smoking and tobacco consumption and has tried to rein in its usage. At University of Wollongong, Australia, research, partnerships and collaborations are aimed at creating an impact in the real world. This sort of influence and hard work in universities in India and across the world should bring affordable medicines and vaccines into the public sphere.
It is UN that makes people believe that life could be easier, safer and better. And it is our duty to not let their faith waver.